spider today. Anyway, here we are, changing up modems. This is going from Distributel to start.ca. I will say that this Distributel, their customer service is pathetic. This is a company that does not keep track of anything you talk about online. Like they say they're going to record your message so they can do quality control and everything. But yet, when you phone them back, they have no idea what you even talk to them about. You do not keep track of anything you talk about. So, it got a little frustrating when it comes to owing them money. They started bugging us for a down payment of $300. Yeah, I'm sorry, but that modem is not worth $300. They used the $300 as a bargaining chip to make it so you'll pay your bill on time, I'm guessing. And even if your bill is even a day late, the $300 will come back to haunt you. So they're constantly threatening us with the $300, and they have a new thing now where they don't have to actually literally send the paperwork in to have your modem disconnected. What they can do is they use a thing called a soft block. And what that is they use the MAC number of your modem, and they can do it all the way from Ottawa, and they just basically block it. So I was being constantly blocked, and then you phone them up, and they're like, oh, we're sorry. We don't know how that happened. I think you're having this little feud with this company, okay? So it was getting really frustrating. My wife was getting really stressed out, so I figured, you know what, screw these guys. If you got such terrible service like that, you deserve to lose customers. So we're going to give start.ca a try. And I'm just about to switch over modems here now. I've been told to do it. And see if this is even up and running yet. Good riddance, Distributel. That was a faithful subscriber for over a year. And, we only got behind a couple of times on the bill. But, other than that, it was paid, so you guys are not going to be missed for all the crap you put us through. Okay, just plug in a very large power supply and we're good to go. I doubt this is going to link up right away, but we'll see. I think Cogeco has to set it up on their end. Then again, it might work right away, I don't know. Basically, I'm pretty sure this should go all solid with one blinking, which would be that one there, likely. But right now, I think it's downloading firmware. Or uploading. The arrow's pointing in, this one's pointing out. Oh, there we go. Now it's going the other way. It's checking the network.
This is a Technicolor modem, so I don't think these lights actually change color. It should go back and forth a couple times to do some tests. Oh, that's going to take a while. Okay, we have solid lights, which is good. And I reset the D-Link. It's in the process of rebooting. And that should be it. Hopefully this is, the MAC number is set up on the Cogeco's side. I'll have a new service through dartstart.ca, which people have been raving about. So I'm looking forward to working with this new company. I'm saving about, I think she said about $40 a month. So that's pretty good. Okay, I think we're ready. We'll check the computer, see if it's even working. Well, not bad. We went from Distributel to start.ca without losing even a minute of internet. Pretty good. You can see it's working. Pretty quick too. Not bad. Later, guys.